Hello, today I'm gonna differentiate between variable, fixed, and mixed cost. This is managerial accounting. The first type of cost, we call it variable cost. Variable cost, it's like wages. For example, if I pay $10, okay, per hour for each labor, okay, worker. So the $10 will not change per hour. Okay, it's gonna be $10 per hour. So if he worked for 5 hours, I'm gonna pay him $50 in total. And if he worked 10 hours, he's gonna be paid $100. Okay, so I multiply 10 with 5 hours, it's gonna be $50. Then I multiply 10 with 10 hours, it's gonna be $100. So as you can see, the $10 per hour did not change. So the variable cost per hour, it's not gonna change. Okay? So variable cost per unit, per hour, per minute will not change. It's gonna remain constant. While for the total variable cost, it's gonna increase with increase in units, and it's gonna decrease with increase in number of units. So with increase in units, it's gonna go up. With decrease in units, it's gonna go down. So as you can see in this question, we are talking about tablets. So here you have the number of tablets or number of units. Here you have the variable cost per tablet, and here you have the total variable cost. So as you can see, here we have increase in number of tablets. Variable cost per tablet, it's not gonna change, it's gonna remain constant. Okay, while for the total variable cost, I'm gonna multiply the number of units by the 55, I'm gonna get the total variable. So as you can see, with increase in number of units, my total variable will also increase. So this is the graph for the total variable cost. When 0 units is produced, my total variable cost will be 0. With increase in units, my total variable cost will go up. So this is the line. The second type of cost is fixed cost. Fixed cost, it's like salaries. So for example, you're gonna be paid $1,000 each month. Okay, it's per period. It has nothing to do with the number of hours you are working. So $1,000 per month. So for example, if you work this month for 20 hours, let's say. So I'm gonna divide $1,000 divided by 20 hours. I'm gonna get $50 per hour. Okay, what's gonna happen if I worked 40 hours this month? So I'm gonna divide 1,000 by 40, it's gonna be what? $25 per hour. Okay, so again, each month I'm gonna be paid $1,000. $1,000, it's not gonna change, so it's gonna be constant as total. If I work 20 hours, my cost per hour will be $50. And if I worked for 40 hours, my cost will be $25 per hour. So as you can see, the fixed cost per hour will go down from 50 to 25 with increase in number of hours from 20 to 40. Total fixed cost is constant, while fixed cost per unit or per hour with increase in number of units, it will go down. With decrease in number of units, it's gonna go up. So again, let's go back to our example. Total fixed cost for this month is $12,000. As you can see, it's gonna remain constant regardless of the number of tablets produced. And here are the numbers of tablets. or number of units from 25 until 100. So with increase in number of units, my total fixed cost remain constant. Now to get the fixed cost per tablet, I'm gonna divide total fixed cost by number of tablets to get this number. So 12,000 divided by 25 is gonna be 480. Now, as you can see, with increase in number of units, the fixed cost per tablet decreased. Okay, so with increase in number of units, my fixed cost per unit will go down. With decrease in number of units, my fixed cost will go up. Now, this is the graph for the total fixed cost. If I produce 0 units or if I produce 100 units, my total fixed cost will remain constant at $12,000. It's not gonna change. So it's a straight line. Now, the third type of cost is mixed cost. Mixed cost means it's fixed cost plus variable cost. Okay, so let's have a look at this question or this example. Number of minutes used. So here is the number of minutes. This is the activity level. Minutes or units or hours. So here it's minutes. Total fixed cost is $100. Total variable cost, it's 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. And the total cost, it's 110, 120, 130, 140, 150. So if you look at the total cost and the number of minutes, okay, this one will not be only fixed cost. Why? Cause it's changing as total, while total fixed cost should be constant. And it's not only variable cost. Why? Cause as you know, variable cost per minute will remain constant. So if I divide 110 by number of minutes, which is 100, it's gonna be 1.1. But if you divide 150 by 500 minutes, you're gonna get 0.3 or 30 cents. So 1.10, it's not the same as 0.30. So it's not only variable cost. So this total cost will be fixed and variable. Okay, so now, as we said, total fixed cost will remain constant. So you pay a subscription each month. For example, you're gonna pay $100 regardless of how many units did you use. While for the variable cost, it's gonna depend on the number of minutes. As you can see, with increase in number of minutes, my total variable cost increased. But to get the variable cost per minute, you're gonna divide $10 by 100 minutes. So it's gonna be 0.10. So if you want to find the variable cost per minute, okay, variable cost per minute, you're gonna divide $10 by 100, so it's gonna be 0.10 or 10 cents dollars per minute. Also, if you divide 20 by 200, you're gonna get the same answer. 30 by 300 minutes, you're gonna get the same answer. So now this is the graph for the mixed cost. As you can see, this is the total fixed cost. I need to pay $100 if I use the phone for 0 minutes or for 500 minutes. I'm gonna pay $100. But for the variable cost, it's gonna start from the zero and go up. For the total cost, which is fixed and variable together, it's gonna start from this point and goes up. Because if I use it for 0 minutes, it's gonna be $100. If I use it for 100 minutes, I'm gonna pay $110. So it's gonna be 110. So it's gonna go up starting from the $100 from this point, which is total fixed cost. Again, for the variable cost and fixed cost, you need to know what are the constants. Okay, so we said for the variable cost, cost per unit will remain constant, while for the fixed cost, the total cost will remain constant. So variable cost as total will increase with increase in volume, which is number of units, and will decrease when the number of units decreases. Now for the fixed cost per unit, it's gonna decrease when volume increases and will increase when volume decreases. Thank you for watching. If you have any question, please leave a comment. Please like, share, and subscribe.